G'day there everyone, welcome to Movie Studio Zen. My name's Derek, also known as Dr. Zen or Dexter. So in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to do multi-cam video editing in Vegas Movie Studio 17 Platinum. And if you don't know what that is, it's going to end up looking like this. Instructions I'm about to show you will work in Vegas Movie Studio Platinum 14, 15, 16 and 17. They'll also work in all versions of Vegas Pro. And if you own an ancient version of Vegas Movie Studio Platinum, so version 13 or older, those older versions technically didn't support multicam video editing, but there is a hack you can do which makes it possible. So if that's you, click the link in the video, wherever that is right now, and you can watch that alternative tutorial. Okie dokie, let's get started. Now, make sure your mind is calm and relaxed and you are 100% switched on, because it gets a little bit technical. So before you do anything, plan out your project. Now I'm talking before we get into onto your computer. I'm going way back to your camera setup. With multiple cameras, what you need to plan out is one of those cameras is going to have your master audio track that all the other videos are synced to. That's going to be the audio that's the high quality audio, right? And that will remain the same while we're switching from one video source to the next. So there's two ways you can do that. You can either have that audio going into one of your video cameras, or you may have an external audio recorder like a Zoom or a Tascam audio with, you know, professional XLR mic inputs to a high quality microphone. So in that setup, you've got four videos and one high quality audio track. And everything will sync to that main audio track so that everything's in sync. Here's our videos. So before I do anything, I'm going to go Project, Save As. And these are my test ones before I did this. Okay, so let's call this Multicam shoot with Dr. Zen. That'll do. Okay, next step to stay organized, what I recommend you do is delete all these default tracks. So press on the first track, hold the shift key down, and press on the last track. Then press the delete key. Now this is more of a Vegas Pro setup now. Staying organized, I changed the name of the files so I know which camera everything is. So I've got a GoPro video, a Logitech webcam, a high quality Sony A7S, and a Sony Xperia mobile phone. The way I did my setup, because it's a tutorial, I hooked in my good quality Rode microphone with my Logitech webcam. So that is going to be my master audio track for syncing everything, because it's got the good, really lovely, juicy, delicious audio. So I'm going to drag that track and let's say yes. Oh, and almost forgot something very important. When you do multicam, make sure all your cameras are recording at the same frame rate. Don't mix like 30 FPS and 25 FPS. That's going to be a nightmare, okay? You could get audio sync issues. Keep it at the same frame rate. Now, it is okay. So my frame rate's going to be 29.97 or 30 FPS. It is okay, though, if you mix frame rates that are in multiples of each other. So if, say, one of your cameras might have been recording at 60 FPS and all the other videos are at 30 FPS. That's okay because you can divide it evenly and so it'll remain nice and smooth. This third audio track is because I'm using the OBS recorder, so I'm just going to delete that. I don't need it. And now let's do some labeling. So double click there. So I'm going to call this, so that's my webcam. Now here, I'm going to call this Alpha Audio. Very important that I remember that. Then the next order, it's up to you what you do. So I'm going to do the GoPro next. I'll do my Sony A7S. And we're running out of room, so I'll use the slider, drag down, and my mobile phone. Now we're up to the most important step in multicam editing, and that is doing a good sync of the audio to every single video so that as everyone's mouths are moving, the sound coming out looks okay and not stupid. Okay, so there's two ways to do audio sync in multicam. If we go to Tools, Multicamera, we've got this option here, synchronize audio to align events. That's an automated way to do the syncing, but sometimes that may not work. So I'll show you both options, right? I think it's best I'll show you the good old fashioned manual method first, then we'll show you the automated way. Because, you know, sometimes things go wrong and you need to know every little trick in the book. Okie dokie, so we can see here, here's our claps on the Alpha Audio channel. So I line that up as best as I can on that first hand clap. Then I press M for marker so we don't lose that point. Then I just roughly drag our video clips sort of, you know, just roughly into place. And I know my face is covering things up, but I'll fix that in a moment. Okay, now we drag it to here. Very good. This one here is a bit of a problem track, but we'll leave that one to last because sometimes accidents happen and the audio for one of the cameras may have not worked, but there is a way to fix that, okay? So we'll leave that to last. First sync we'll do is on the main video, and the second one. So I'm hovering at the top of the timeline, or just so we've got more space to move around here. Then using the wheel on my mouse, I'm zooming in. And okay, we can see that's out. So so you don't get confused, I'll just mute. I'll go a bit dark now. I'll mute that track, we'll leave to last. So first off, drag it across until it's roughly right and then zoom in. And what we want to do is we want to get as close as we can. So on my marker that I created, I can see it's not quite right. So that's even closer. So I've moved it to there. Do more zooming in. And sorry, I'm making sure you guys can see all this. Now, I'm going to grab hold of the main cursor. And we're now down to the frame by frame level. So that's only on a 30 frame per second timeline. That's only 1/30th of a second between here and here. If I drag this video to here, we can see the gap is bigger between the waveforms. Whereas here it's not so that is as good as the sync we'll get on that one. Now to lock that into place, hold the control button down, select video one, audio one, then video two, and audio two, then press G for group, and that's now locked them in place so they won't move out of sync. Now I'm going to just drag up the timeline a little more. Let's do the video on the bottom. Drag that across. This time, when you're doing a sync, don't sync it to the second video. Always sync back to the master video, okay? So zooming in on the mouse again. And grabbing hold of that cursor. And that is as good as we're going to get. Now we do another group. We repeat the process. Highlight the first video. Hold the control button down. Select video and audio. Video and audio. Video and audio. So all six of those tracks will stay in sync, and then press the G button. Okay. Okay, I'm going to zoom back out. Now, we were in a little bit of luck on this dodgy video here, the worst one till last, because there was a tiny little blip there. But let's imagine there's no blip. So what you've got to do is now visually find the hand clap. So now I'll drag that back down. And we can cheat a little bit because I've got that little blip. Zoom in. Okay. And if I grab hold of that main timeline cursor, we can see where my hand claps together. All right, creates the sound. So we want to find the same point on this weird video here. So mute the top video so we can see the video below. And there we go. There's the, pretty sure that's it. Oh, hang on. Wait a second. It might be over here. We better do a solo of the video and the audio. Oh no, that's not going to work. Hang on. Oh man. This is good that this happens because it shows you the problems that can arise. Let's have a look there again. One, two, three. So there's the third clap, so to speak. So I'm going to grab hold. How do we do this? Going to grab hold of here and just drag that to here, if you know what I'm saying. No, I drag too fast. I drag it back a bit. And I think I got it. Yeah, I think I got it. It's synced. So then the final thing to do is let's go all. What you can do is press the F11 key, right? And we'll do a final grouping. Hold the control button down, select absolutely everything, and press G. Now everything is glued together. So that's how you do, pressing F11 again. That's how you do a manual sync. Wow, that was a bit of a nightmare. Anyway, but that's what happens. Okay, so off camera, I ungrouped everything, right? Because now I want to show you the automated method, because if it works, that's the quickest way to do it. So I'm going to just drag all this back to, whoops, don't do that. Drag everything back to here. Destroy my beautiful sync. Anyway. Let's even get rid of that, all right? So, the automated method, this is what you do. We need to select only the audio tracks that you want to sync. So, in the situation where you've got four videos and you may have an extra master audio track, you want to include that as well. So, hold the control button down, select audio one, audio two, audio 3, audio 4. Okay, then go tools, multi-camera, synchronize audio to align events. Now, obviously, if you've got videos that are like really long, like more than an hour, and your computer is a little bit slow, doing this may take quite a lot of time. But, you know, as you can see, my little test videos are quite short, so it happens very quickly. And watch what happens. Oh. Now, when you see that, right, don't freak out. I'm glad I did, because I mucked up again, right? Now, the reason why I did that is because this track here that's got the crappy audio, it's screwing everything up. So click outside and do this. Hold the control button down and only select the tracks that look like they've got a decent audio waveform. And ignore this one here. Now let's do audio sync and see what happens. Tools, multi-camera, sync to audio. Cross our fingers, everybody. Cross everything on your body that can be crossed. But don't cross for too long. You might still want to have children. And well, let's see what happens. Boom. So, zoom in. And we can see that Vegas hasn't done a bad job at all. And I think Vegas may have done basically the same as what I did. Okay, so that's auto. But as you can see, when you've got a crappy track that's all screwed up, you're going to have to do it manually. So if the auto works, it's great, but sometimes it doesn't. Okay, the fun continues. So once again, just before you do anything, make sure everything gets locked into place. So let's do a final grouping. Hold the control button. Actually, this time we can do this. Hold the shift key down, press the very top track, then select the very bottom track. Oh man, hang on, something's going wrong. Do it again, shift, top, very bottom, there, they're all selected. Press G for group and see how it's all going in one big thing, right? Okie dokie. So just to tidy everything up a little bit, because we don't need all that there. I'll just drag. Yeah, and you can see that when you see here, when you're dragging, see how everything's grouped. So let's put it to there. And I'll drag this to here. And before I do anything, I'm going to call this sync 2. So everything's good. So now, after all that bullshit, we're ready to turn on multicam editing. Okay, so after all that nonsense that we just went through, I know it's a bit torturous, but it is important, we are finally ready to do some multicam video editing. Everything's ready, everything's synced. What we've got to do now is tell Vegas what parts of the timeline we want to turn into a multicam track. This is important. Remember, the audio from that, that's crap. We don't want that. Not, there's nothing to hear. We don't want that either. We don't want that either, because we've got our one delicious, beautiful audio stream that was done with the good microphone, okay? Now, sometimes you may want to switch to different things, but most of the time, you want to stick to just one good audio stream, but then including four different cameras. So this is what we do. Obviously, we select all the videos. So hold the control button down, select video number one, make sure you select the good audio track. We definitely want that. Video number two, but ignore audio two. Forget about it. Video number three, ignore its audio as well. Video number four, and we don't want the audio from that either. So we've got all them. you can let go of the control button, go tools, multi-camera, create multi-camera track. All right. And finally, go tools, multi-camera, enable multi-camera editing. Now you may be saying, but look, the audio tracks are still here. Yeah, they are, but we didn't select them. They're not part of that group. So what you can do, or what you have to do, is just mute them. You could delete them if you wanted to, but it's always good to just keep them there in case something goes wrong. You need to resync for whatever reason. So we're left with that one good audio track and four different videos, but they're all like stacked on top of one another at the moment. So we'll drag this down. Okay. And let me just start about that point there, right? So, and I'll scroll in a little bit. I'll press M for marker just for so I know where my beginning point is. So what you do is you press play. Oh, I better lower the audio so that's not annoying. Press play. And as you press play, you select which screen you want is going to be the new cut. So starting off here, let's go to this one here. Go to the widescreen. Side screen. Maybe go back up. And press stop. Now remember, if you make a mistake in a cut, you can always do the old Control Z or Control Z, as I like to say. So let's do a little playback of that.
And you've got some really nice audio waveform peaks.
Oops, stop. Made a mistake, sorry. After you do your cuts, to play it back, there is a shortcut. Go Tools, Multi-camera, and just disenable multi-camera editing, and that just brings it back to, you know, one video at a time. So we'll do that. Press play.
And you've got some really nice audio waveform peaks in Vegas where you can match everything up. Okay, so that's about it. For this tutorial, you're not going to sit here and watch me do anything.
Okay. Now, there are a few other little tricks that you can also do. This is really cool what I'm about to show you. So to do this one, we'll zoom in. So as you're playing back your edit, you'll see each video, the name of that different video camera is sitting there, right? So we've got, that's camera 4 of 4, that's camera 2 of 4, 1 of 4, 3 of 4. So if you went, oh, I meant to switch to a different camera view, you can right-click on top of the video, go to Take, and select a different camera view. See, we've got the four different camera views here. So let's say go to the mobile phone instead. And then it switches it over, right? And other things you can do is you can still manually trim, just like you normally would, and make it, like shorter or longer just by moving things around on the timeline, and everything will still stay in sync. But yeah, so just remember, if you want to change the take, right click on the video, take, and change the take. Okay, I think that's it. Like most tutorials, the bulk of the time is all in the technical boring stuff, but when you actually get to the real meat and potatoes, it's quite quick. So that's multi-camera video editing in Vegas Movie Studio Platinum 17. Hope that was helpful, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.